for the very funny Mr. Julius. Walgreens and shit? Oh man, let me look around and see if I'm gonna fuck with somebody tonight. Okay, alright. Alright, well, let me start off with, I just went to, my son just graduated from kindergarten, right? And, you know, they tell, they say the name of the child, and then they say what they're gonna do when they grow old, right? So you heard all kind of things. You heard firefighter, policeman, boxer, football player, veterinarian. So when they got to my son, he kind of lost me, because when they got to him, they asked, they said, Jabril Fogle, he wants to be a nurse. Now look here, I mean, I have nothing against being a nurse, but I'm just being real. I would have rather him said a doctor or something, right? So, you know, he told me last week he wanted to be a comedian, right? So I get home and I said, son, where did this nurse thing come from? This is the first I heard of this here. He says, well, son, he says, well, daddy, did you think that was funny? I said at the time I didn't. But you got some potential, son. You got some potential. Keep it up. Before I started doing this comedy, I was in the U.S. Army. I served 20 years.
All right.
Thank you. Something else I used to do that might surprise you was I was a professional boxer for 10 years. And I hung around a lot longer than what I should have, like a lot of other athletes and boxers do. I was still fighting in my 40s. And about 5 years ago, I was 40 years old, I fought a fighter by the name of Sergey Krushenkovalev. Now, if you don't know who Sergey Krushenkovalev is, currently he's the light heavyweight champion of the world right now. He's 29-0 with 26 knockouts. And he also happens to be Russian. He's the real life Ivan Drago, not that fake Hollywood bullcrap. And in the first round of our fight, this Bama Jamma hit my ass so damn hard. He actually knocked some sense into my ass. I actually heard myself talking to myself during the round. But I was talking to myself in a voice that was a little bit disrespectful. I said, Julius, why in the hell is your 40-year-old ass in the ring with this young, heavy-handed, gorilla-strength motherfucker? Go sit your old black ass down somewhere. So I came back to the corner after taking a thorough ass whipping. Coach started giving some instructions. I said, look here, coach. You can keep all them damn instructors. We get ready to take this shit back to the hotel room. When I come back to this corner again, you gonna be pulling them goddamn gloves off my head. And that's exactly what the hell happened. J-O got TKO'd in the second round by Sergey Krushenkovalev. And that's the true story. Now they say there's two things a boxer loses after he's taken too many punches to the head. They say the first thing he loses is his memory. The second thing they say he loses is... I can never remember what this is. I like to go to a lot of the boxing gym too. I like to go see kids working out. As long as they're staying off the drugs and staying out of trouble, I try to go out and help, right? So I was in the gym one day and I see these two boys, they was boxing against each other. It was fun, right? And he never got caught. The guy didn't make him pay for it. So when he got out the ring, I walked over to him and I said, why do you fight with your hands down like that? He said, oh, I just like to fight like that. Now I mean? Now one thing when you're trying to communicate with these kids today, you gotta be able to speak the lingo and to understand and communicate effectively better, right? So I said, yeah, okay, I see what you mean. You see that guy over there? I said, go over there and ask him his name and how long he's been fighting with his hands down like that, because he likes to fight like that also. So he went over there and asked him, and he came back, he had a crazy look on his face. He said, I couldn't understand a word he said. It sounded like he had marbles in his mouth. I said, well, that's